Hello nurses and hello top notchers. Welcome back again to our YouTube channel at welcome na naman sa ating panibagong rationalization para sa ating community health nursing. So ngayon pag-usapan natin ang ating natitira at nalalabing mga katanungan sa ating NP1 para sa ating nalalapit na board exam. Okay, so situation. The public health nurse must have an understanding of demography which should support healthcare plan. Okay, so question number 74. Demography is concerned with the study of population. Which of the following are included in demographic profile? A. Size, composition, health status, and environment. B. Change in population, distribution, and health status. C. Size, distribution, composition, and change in population. Or D. Size, distribution, and composition. Okay, so which of the following are included in demographic profile? So is it letter A, letter B, letter C, or letter D? Okay, so the correct answer here in your question number 74, if we say demographic profile, okay, demographic profile consists the size, the distribution, the composition, and the change in population. Okay? So hindi po kasama diyan yung health status of your community, okay? So the correct answer here is letter C. It is the size, distribution, composition, and the change in population. Next, question number 75. Based on the 2017 demography report on July 2016 estimate, the Philippine population has reached A, 140 million. B, 120 million, C, 102 million, or D, 85 million. Okay, so take note, ang tinatanong po sa ating question number 75 is yung 2016 estimate, July 2016 estimate ng Philippine population. Okay, so ilan na ba, ilang million na bang Pilipino ang meron sa Pilipinas noong 2017, okay? So, based on the 2017 demographic report, okay, the Philippine population has reached 102 million, okay? 102 million based on 2017 demographic report. Okay, so that is the July 2016 estimate that the Philippine population has reached 102 million. So letter C is the correct answer. Okay? So based on the 2017 demographic report on July 2016 estimate, the total population of the Philippines as recorded by the UNESCO in 2016 stands at just over 103 million. Okay? So the Philippines' annual population growth rate is 1.5% and its fertility rate is 2.9, both in decline. That is according to UNESCO 2016. And on 2017, meron na po tayong 105 million Filipinos. On 2018, meron na po tayong 106 million of Filipinos. And noong 2019, meron na pong 108 million Filipinos. And at year 2020, meron na po tayong total of 109 million of Filipinos. So, yun po yung ating tatandaan. Noong 2017, 105, 2018, 106, 2019, 108, and 2020, 109 million. But based on your July 2016 estimate on 2017 demographic report, meron po tayong 102 million Filipinos. Okay? So, letter C is the correct answer. Okay, so next, number 76. There are three demographic variables in population growth. Which one is not included? So, take note, ang tanong is not included. So, negative answer po yung ating isasagot. So, which one will not affect population growth? A, fertility. B, migration. C, morbidity. Or D, mortality. Okay, isa-isahin po natin. Pag sinabi natin fertility, meron yung kinalaman sa mga sinisilang na sanggol, okay? So fertility rate. So pag madami yung sinisilang na sanggol, it will affect your population growth. The next, migration, okay? Migration can also affect our population growth. So between letter C and letter D, morbidity versus your mortality. If we say morbidity, ibig sabihin niyan mga sakit, okay? Diseases. And if we say mortality, it's all about death. Okay? So, yun. Alin ang mas nakaka-affect sa population growth? Is it the presence of diseases or morbidities or the death or mortality? So, the correct answer here is letter C. Okay? Letter C kasi morbidity, mga sakit po yan. Okay? Unlike doon sa mortality kasi, mortality kapag maraming namamatay, especially mga namamatay sa mga sakit or any causes, okay? It will affect our population, okay? So, the correct answer is letter C, morbidity is not included in your three demographic variable, okay? So, letter C po yung sagot natin dito. So, take note that your fertility, mortality, and migration all affect the size of society's population. Demographic factors that determine population growth and decline are fertility, mortality, and migration. So, morbidity is not included. So, letter C is the correct answer. Next, number 77. Population structure is a diagram of population typically presented in a pyramid-like style format based on A. Sex and educational attainment, B. Age and fertility, C. Age and civil status, or D. Age and sex. So, tinatanong dito kung ano daw yung makikita natin sa ating population pyramid. So, sa population pyramid, it is a structure or a diagram which will represent the age and sex of the population. Okay, so hindi po dyan kasali yung civil status, yung fertility, at saka yung educational attainment ng mga tao. So, ang nandoon lang sa ating population pyramid is only your age and sex. Okay, so age and sex po yung nandoon sa ating population pyramid. So, ganito po yung itsura ng ating population pyramid. Okay, so based on 2015, meron po tayo dyan 101.8 millions of Filipino. So, kung makikita natin, dyan na hati yung male sa female. So, that is the sex or the gender. Okay? So, yun po yun. So, age and sex po yung population pyramid. So, the correct answer here is letter D. Okay? Okay, so next, number 78. An aging population refers to a phenomenon in which the median age of the population in a country rises significantly compared to the total population. This is caused by any or combination of the following. A. Declining birth rate. B. Rising life expectancy. 3. Decreased fertility. 4. Increased child survival. Or 5. Better health. Okay? So, letter A, 1, 2, 3, and 4. B, 1, 2, 4, and 5. C, 1, 2, and 3, or D, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, or all of the above. Okay? Okay, so pag sinabi po natin aging population refers to the rise in median age of the population. So take note, in year 2015, ang median age sa Pilipinas is 24.3 years pa lang. Pero nung 2020 na, naging 25.69 or 25.7 years na po siya, okay? So, the current median age in the Philippines is 25.7 years, okay? So, pag nagkakaroon ng aging population, it has a negative impact in the economy, okay? Why? Because it leads to shortage of workers. So, which causes your aging population? So, the causes of your aging population may be caused by any or combination of a declining birth rate, rising life expectancy, and the decrease in fertility rate. So, 1, 2, and 3 only. So, the correct answer here is letter C. So, 1, 2, and 3, these are the causes of your aging population. Next, situation. As a public health nurse in your local community, it is one of your main responsibilities to educate the community about good health practices. Next, number 79. During a community forum, you discuss about herbal medicines. You explain to the participants that Botica sa Paso is done by A. Cultivating herbal plants in vacant or unused lots, B. Growing herbal plants in pots, C. Planting herbs along the barangay streets, or D. Experimenting with herbal decoction. Okay, so Botica sa Paso. Okay, paso ang keyword natin dito. So, saan mo itatanim yung ating mga herbal medicines? So, sa paso. So, letter B is the correct answer. So, growing herbal plants in pots. So, one of the highlights in Healthy Barrio is the Botica sa Paso campaign. The goal of this project is to maintain herbal plants in pots for family use. So, ang goal kasi ng ating Botica sa Paso campaign is yung magkaroon po sila ng accessible and available sources ng medicinal plants sa mga bahay-bahay, okay? So, ngayon, ang ginawa nila, nagtanim po sila mga herbal plants sa mga Paso. Kaya siya tinawag na Butika sa Paso kasi doon sila sa Paso. So letter boy is the correct answer. Hindi sa unused lots or hindi sa Barangay Street. So letter B is the correct answer for number 79. Okay, so number 80. You also discuss about having a healthy market, which means that the community should A. sell fresh and healthy foods only, B. organize recycling teams, C. collect garbage and recycle them, or D. dispose waste and garbage separately. Okay, so healthy market po ang tinatanong natin. So, in your healthy market, hindi naman po ibig sabihin na since sinabing healthy market ay mga fresh and healthy foods na lang ang ibebenta doon or ititinda roon. So, mali po yung letter A natin. So, pag sinabi natin healthy market, tinuturuan natin yung mga vendors at mga tenants natin doon to dispose their waste and garbage separately. So, magkaroon po tayo ng proper waste and garbage disposal. So, letter D is the correct answer in your healthy market. So, sabi dito, in healthy market, the community should dispose waste and garbage separately. In healthy market, there should be adequate water supply, proper drainage, and well-maintained toilet facilities. So, proper garbage and waste disposal is observed by vendors and cleanliness is maintained. So, affordable quality foods and has a well-organized and honest market system. So, ang focus ng ating healthy market ay hindi yung mabinibenta lang, okay? So, ang focus din dito is yung sanitation sa palengke. So, letter D is the correct answer. So, it is involved in your or included dito yung proper waste and garbage disposal. So, letter D is the correct answer. Okay, so number 81. As part of your topic, you shared about the strategy that should be initiated by students and teachers for a healthy school. What is this strategy about? A. Implementing environmental sanitation activities. B. CPR demonstration. C. Selection of better school doctors and school nurses. Or D. Scrapbooking using recycled materials. Okay, so initiated by students and teachers. So, alin daw dito yung healthy school? So, healthy school is about the strategy of implementation of environmental sanitation activities. Ito yung tinuturuan din natin yung may estudyante natin kung paano alagaan yung ating kapaligiran. Yung nag-gardening po sila, nagdidilig ng halaman, at naglilinis po sa mga paligid. Okay? So, letter A is the correct answer for your healthy school, implementing environmental sanitation activities. So, healthy school strategies about implementing environmental sanitation activities. Health instruction provided through classroom or extracurricular activities is to maintain adequate basic health services to both pupils, teachers, and other personnel. So, sample school initiative din natin dito is the Little Doctor Program. Outstanding students are chosen yearly on the basis of their healthy conditions and lifestyle. Pero ang focus po natin dito is yung ina-initiate ng ating students and teachers. So, ano po bang pwede natin i-initiate dito? So, pwede natin initiate dito yung ating letter A, okay? Environmental sanitation activities. Letter A is the correct answer. Okay, so next, number 82. One of the participants ask you about what herbal plants to use when treating diarrhea. You answered that young leaves of blanc can be used as a home remedy. A. Chaang gubat. B. Sambong. C. Lagundi. Or D. Bayabas. Okay, so let's try to eliminate options. So, una nating tatanggalin dito si letter C, si Lagundi or Vitex Nagundo. Okay, so si Lagundi ay una nating tatanggalin kasi si Lagundi ay for cough, cold, asthma, and fever. Okay, so yan po yung gamot na para sa airway problems or mga respiratory illnesses. So, letter B naman natin, sambong. Sambong ang next na tatanggalin natin kasi sambong is the diuretic herbal medicine kasi it is used to treat kidney stones or kidney problem but not kidney infections. Okay? So, tanggal si B, tanggal si C. So, ngayon, paano na ngayon yan? Si Chaang gubat ay ginagamit din natin for diarrhea. Si bayabas ay ginagamit din natin sa diarrhea. So, alin dito sa dalawa ang ginagamitan natin ng young leaves? Okay? So, si Chaang gubat or your bayabas. So, the correct answer here is your bayabas, okay? So, bayabas is used to treat also diarrhea. So, several studies have shown that guava leaf extract is antimicrobial, okay? This means that it can neutralize harmful microbes in the gut that can cause diarrhea. Okay? So, it will also reduce the episodes of diarrhea and constipation. So, pag sinabi natin bayabas, meron tayong mnemonics dito. We have your sugat mnemonics. So, S for stomach flu or diarrhea. U for use for wound washing. And G for GI infection like your amoeba. And A, antiseptic activity. And T for toothache. Kapag toothache po yan, ginagargle po natin yung ating decoction. So, how to prepare your bayabas? To prepare your bayabas, the young leaves can be boiled and taken 3 to 4 times a day for diarrhea. So, for your toothache naman, it can be a warm decoction for gargle. Okay, so stomach flu is your diarrhea. So, yung young leaves ng bayabas yung ginagamit natin sa ating diarrhea. So, the correct answer here is letter D, bayabas young leaves. Then next, number 83, one of the new mothers attending the discussion wants to know about vaccination. One of the key information you share is that A, diarrhea and malnutrition are contraindicated. B, if the vaccination schedule is interrupted, it is necessary to restart. C, it is safe to vaccinate a sick child who is suffering from a minor illness. Or D, minor infections with low-grade fever like below 38.5 degrees Celsius is contraindicated. So, take note, ang hinahanap po natin ditong sagot ay positive answer kasi hindi po negative yung question natin. So, positive answer po yung hahanapin natin kasi positive yung question. So, alin daw dito yung key information na isa-share mo sa new mothers, okay, about your vaccination. So, tingnan natin ang letter A. Diarrhea and malnutrition are contraindicated. Okay, so that is false. Okay, mali po yan. Okay, mali ang letter A kasi diarrhea and malnutrition are not contraindication for immunization. Tandaan niyo po yan. So the more na malnourished ang bata, the more na kailangan po niya ng bakuna. Kasi kapag malnourished siya, mas prone po siya sa mga sakit, sa mga EPI diseases natin. So letter A is wrong answer. So letter B. Dito naman sa ating letter B, sabi dito, if the vaccination schedule is interrupted, it is necessary to restart. No, it is not necessary to restart your immunization kapag na-interrupt yung schedule. So, mas maaga mong nalaman na nagkaroon ng delay sa next dose ng immunization ng bata, okay? Kailangan agad-agad natin mapabakunahan yung bata. And after na maibigay natin yung shot na yon, kailangan pa rin natin sundin yung required interval between doses. Okay, so it is not necessary to restart if the schedule of immunization is interrupted. So, wrong din yung letter B natin. So, next letter C. It is safe to vaccinate a sick child who is suffering from a minor illness. Yes, that is true. Okay, so that is the correct answer. Letter C is the correct answer. Why? Kasi pag mga minor conditions lang naman, these are the false contraindication for immunization. So, kung may lagnat siya, basta hindi siya lalagpas ng 38.5 degrees Celsius, pwede po siyang bakunahan. So, a less than 38.5 degrees Celsius fever is not a contraindication for immunization. Above 38.5 may delay immunization. Okay? Pero, yung below 38.5, that is a false contraindication. Ano pa? So, pag meron siyang diarrhea, cough and colds, malnutrition, vomiting, these are not a contraindication for immunization. Pero ang absolute contraindication ng immunization is the presence of your allergic reaction, especially kapag nagkaroon siya ng anaphylactic reaction from the first dose of its vaccination. So, yun yung absolute na contraindication sa pagpapabakuna. Pero pag mga minor illnesses lang, hindi po yan contraindication for immunization. So, letter A, letter B, and letter D are incorrect answers. So, the correct answer here is letter C. Okay, so next, number 84, the traditional antihelmintic is A, Acapulco, B, Oregano, C, Kalachuchi, or D, Niognyogan. Okay, so if we say antihelmintic means an herbal medicine which has an action to expel intestinal worms and intestinal parasites. So is it A, B, C, or D? So the correct answer here is letter D, Niognyogan is the traditional antihelmintic drug natin. Kasi itong oregano hindi naman po siya part ng ating 10 herbal meds approved by the DOH. Pero ang oregano naman, ginagamit po natin niya na sa mga respiratory illnesses like your crow, asthma, and bronchitis. Okay? And yung kalachuchi, hindi rin po siya kasali sa ating 10 approved herbal meds by the DOH. Yung letter A natin, yung Acapulco. Acapulco is used as your antifungal. Okay, antifungal po siya. So antifungal parasite, like for your ringworm, like for your athlete's foot, the tinea flava, yan po yung ginagamit naman natin for your fungal infections. Acapulco for fungal infection. So the correct answer here is the antihelminthic drug Niognyogan. So take note, ang Niognyogan ay tinetake po natin yan 2 hours after supper or after po ng hapunan. Okay? So bawal pong bigyan yung mga batang less than 4 years old sa ating Niognyogan kasi sila pa po yung target ng ating deworming program. So sa Niognyogan, ang tinetake po natin dito is yung buto. Okay, pwedeng yung raw seeds or yung dried seed po niya. Okay, so yung buto, yun yung tinetake natin. So after ng 1 week at wala pa rin pagbabago, pwede pong ulitin yung pagtake ng buto. Okay, or yung seed ng ating Niognyogan. So pag adult, 8 to 10 seeds. Kapag children naman po, average of 5 to 6 seeds naman po yan. Okay, so letter D, Niognyogan is the traditional anti-helminthic drug. Okay, so next, number 85, the herbal medicine appropriate for urolithiasis is A, Acapulco, B, Sambong, C, Yerba Buena, or D, Ulasimang Bato. So, urolithiasis is the kidney stone formation. So, alin daw dito ang pwede? So, letter A, mali po yan kasi that is for antifungal po yan. Letter C, pain reliever po yan. And letter D, for uric acid naman po yan. So, the correct answer here is letter B, Sambong. Kasi urolithiasis is kidney stone formation. So yung Sambong kasi good for the diuresis po yan. Pampaihi po yung letter B, yung Sambong. So take it in the morning, not at night. So calcium oxalate stones comprise a large number of kidney stones. So number 1 daw na nagkukos ng kidney stone ay yung mga calcium oxalate. So Sambong is an herbal medicine that is clinically proven to dissolve kidney stones and reduce the size and number of urinary tract stones. As a diuretic, Sambong is an herb used to treat urolithiasis or urinary tract or kidney stones, but not kidney infection. Take note, hindi po niya matitreat ang kidney infection. Only kidney stones po yan. Yung letter D naman natin, Ulasimang Bato, yan yung pansit-pansitan. Okay? Yan yung heart-shaped leaves na herbal meds na makikita natin sa mga shed and dump places. Okay? Yung mga parang hugis puso yung kanyang dahon na translucent green. So, Ulasimang Bato has a uric acid lowering property. So, it prevents and treat gouty arthritis. While your Yerba Buena is the pain reliever herbal medicine. Good for headache, toothache, swollen gums, insect bites, and itchiness. So, the correct answer is the Sambong. Letter B for urolithiasis. Next, number 86. Butika ng Bayan refers to a drug outlet wherein primary non-prescription generic drugs are sold or made available. Which one is not included? A. Cotrimoxazole, B. Amoxicillin, C. Aspirin, or D. Metformin. So, ano daw ang hindi ibinebenta sa butika ng bayan? So, not included. Okay, gamot na mura sa butika ng bayan. So, letter A. Cotrimoxazole, B. Amoxicillin, C. Aspirin, or D. Metformin. So, Cotrimoxazole, amoxicillin, and metformin are drugs available and being sold in the butika ng bayan. So, letter C is the correct answer. Aspirin is not included or not being sold or made available in butika ng bayan. So, in your butika ng bayan, it is managed by your NGO and it is supervised by your pharmacist. Okay, so at least 2 vendors natin dyan, at least 2 BHW. So, ano po ba yung mga binibenta dyan na gamot? So, meron po tayo ditong Cotrimoxazole, Amoxicillin, Metoprolol, Captopril, Metformin, Glibenclamide, Paracetamol, the Rives Medication for TB, and Salbutamol. So, yun po yung mga binibenta dyan. So, yung aspirin, hindi po natin yan mabibili sa butika ng bayan. Bakit hindi po yan pinagbibili sa butika ng bayan? Salicylic acid or aspirin is never kept in butika because of its effect. Ano ba yung mga effects ng ating aspirin? Number 1, anticoagulant po yan. So, anticoagulant, so it is highly dangerous to dengue patients. That is why it is not available in butika and health center. So, hindi yan available kasi yung ating aspirin, meron po siyang anticoagulant property, ay yung dengue is nagkakos ng hemorrhage po yan. So, bawal po yan kasi baka mamaya, baka may bumili ng aspirin at magkos po yan ng further injury or damage sa katawan ng pasyenteng may dengue. Okay? So, hindi po yan pinagbibili sa butika ng bayan. Next situation, Public Health Nurse Gabriela is tasked for the day to administer vaccination to pediatric clients in the barangay she covers. She, along with the team of midwives, should be knowledgeable on how to provide with the most effective, necessary, and safest vaccination. So, question number 87. The foundation of medication administration is the application for the rights of medication administration. Which of the following is not included in these rights? Okay, so take note. Kung maaalala nyo, meron po tayo mga 10 rights in medication administration. So, A, right route, B, right patient, C, right dosage, or D, right price. So, ang hindi kasali po dito, not included here is the letter D, right price. Okay? So, letter D is the correct answer. So, nurses are responsible for ensuring the safe and quality patient care at all times. So, research on medical administration errors showed that there is 60% error mainly in the form of wrong time, rate, and wrong dose of medication. So, some medication errors causes permanent disability and for others, the errors are fatal. So, sabi dito, 60% daw ng error rate ay galing sa or dahil sa wrong time of drug administration, wrong rate of drug administration, and the wrong dose of drug administration. So, ngayon, ang tinanong kasi dyan sa ating question kanina is kung anong hindi kasali sa right of medication administration. So, wala naman po tayong right price doon, okay? So, walang right price doon. So, ano po ba yung mga 10 rights in medication administration, okay? For safe patient care. So, number one, right drug. So, para makasigurado tayo ng right drug ang ibibigay natin, you must read the labels 3 times. Take note, 3 times mong babasahin yung label ng medication. The next, there should be a right patient. So, para ma-identify natin yung pasyente na maayos, we must use the 2 identifier system. Paano po yan? So, ask the patient to state her name or his name and birth date. Hindi lang yung pangalan, kailangan kasama po yung birth date. Pag nasabi po niya yan, kailangan mo ding i-compare sa ID bracelet po niya. Okay? So, pag hindi available yung patient kasi tulog or wala po siyang malay, pwede po nating tanungin yung identification niya sa kanyang relative. Okay? The next, right dose. Next, the right route. Next, the right time and frequency. And the right documentation. Ano pa? Right history assessment. Next, the right drug approach. And take note, the patient has the right to refuse. And number 9, right drug-to-drug interaction and evaluation. And the last number here is right education and right information for the patient about its medication. So, these are the 10 rights of drug administration to ensure safe patient care. So, right price is not included. Okay, so next, number 88. When conducting parents' education on immunization, which of the following considerations should Nurse Gabriela include? Number 1, welcome and greet child and family. Number 2, explain the vaccines to be administered. Number 3, refuse entry to those who came late. Number 4, informs attendees about the procedures to be done. Or number 5, provide parents time to ask questions. Or number 6, refrain from answering questions from patient. So, ang hinahanap po natin sa question number 88 is the positive answer. Okay? So, tama naman na i-welcome mo and i-greet mo yung child and family upon na sila ay makarating sa ating clinic or sa hospital. Okay? Then, you must explain the vaccines to be administered. So, number 3, refuse entry. Mali po yun. So, hindi porket na late size, hindi mo na sila babakunahan. So, mali po yung ating choice number 3. Yung option number 3, tanggal na agad sa choices yung may mga number 3. So, tanggal na yung B, eliminated na rin yung letter D. So, natitira ang A at letter C. So, number 4, inform attendees about the procedures to be done. So, same po yung A tsaka C na may number 4 kasi pasok po yung option number 4. Number 5, provide parents time to ask questions. So, pasok din po yung number 5. At number 6, refrain from answering. From the word refrain, huwag mo daw silang sagutin kapag meron silang katanungan, okay? So, mali po yun. Kapag meron po silang mga katanungan, kailangan open yung nurse to answer their queries or questions. So, tanggal yung number 6. So, the correct answer here is letter C. When conducting parents' education on immunization, the nurse must welcome and greet the client, explain the vaccines to be administered, and inform all attendees about the procedure to be done. If information was provided, provide the parents time to ask questions. So, hayaan mo silang magtanong din kapag meron silang gustong i-clarify or gusto pang malaman. So, letter C is the correct answer. Okay, so next, question number 89. When handling vaccines, the first step Nurse Gabriela should do is to A. Select the correct needle size, B. Reconstitute using diluent supplied, C. Check the content prior to drawing up, or D. Check the vial for expiration date. So take note, ang tinatanong po dito is the first step in handling vaccines. So this is a common board question. So when handling vaccine, the first step is always check the vial for expiration date. So pagkatanggal mo pa lang sa kanyang storage refrigerator or sa ating storage unit, kailangan mong i-check yung ating vial kung pwede pa siyang gamitin or hindi na. So, meron siyang nakalagay na expiration date. Pag walang expiration date na nakalagay doon, you must check the vial monitor. So, meron po kasi dyan na may mga VVM or yung vaccine vial monitor na by visual inspection lang, malalaman mo na kung pwede pang gamitin yung bakuna or hindi na. Okay? So, take note, the first step when handling a vaccine is always to check the vial for its expiration date. The expiration date has not passed. So, expired vaccine or diluent should never be used. Okay? So, bawal po kasing gumamit na may expired na bakuna. So, kailangan siguraduhin muna natin na yung mga bakuna natin is hindi pa lumagpas sa kanilang expiration date. Okay? So, letter D is the correct answer. Okay, so next, number 90. If more than one vaccine is given, the following guidelines should be observed except. So, negative answer po ang hanapin natin dito, yung hindi mo i-observe. So, letter A, do not give more than one dose of the same vaccine in one session. B, do not use the same arm or leg for more than one injection. C, give doses of the same vaccine at the correct intervals. Or D, use the same syringe and needle in administering two vaccines. So, not be observed is letter D. Use the same syringe and needle in administering two vaccines. Take note, never use a same syringe when injecting vaccines, or especially kahit nito ay two vaccines pang ibibigay mo, never use the same syringe. Okay? Use a single-use syringe po dyan. Okay? Do not give more than one dose of the same vaccine in one session. Tama po yan. Kapag sinabing 0.5 ml lang yung required dose, 0.5 ml lang ibibigay natin. Do not use the same arm or leg for more than one injection. Yes, never use the same arm or leg. But kapag hindi naman maiwasan, kailangan natin ng 1 inch apart sa ating injection site. Okay, so letter D is the correct answer. Kasi yung letter C, tama din naman kasi yung letter C, to give doses of the same vaccine at correct intervals. Okay, so letter D is not to be observed. So yan po yung except natin. Letter D is the correct answer. Okay, so next, number 91. When documenting the procedures done, which of the following should not be recorded? So, negative answer po yung hinahanap natin dito because it is asking you for not to be recorded. Okay, after your vaccination, alin dito ang hindi natin nire-record? A, date, B, lot number, C, manufacturer, or D, needle gauge. So, the correct answer here is letter D, needle gauge. So, needle gauge, hindi po yan nire-record sa ating documentation sa ating immunization. So, letter D is the correct answer. So, according to the National Childhood Vaccine Injury Act of 1986 as amended, it requires that the date of administration, vaccine manufacturer, the lot number, the name, address, and the title of the nurse or healthcare provider must be recorded in the patient permanent medical record. Okay? So, pag nagpabakuna ang pasyente, kailangan i-record mo daw yung date of administration of the vaccine, what is the vaccine's manufacturer, the lot number of the vaccine, yung name ng ating nurse or ng ating health worker, yung address niya, and yung title niya. Kung nurse ba siya, midwife ba siya. So, the correct answer here is letter D.